السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، the people of Quraysh, when they got hold of Khubayb ibn Adi رضي الله تعالى عنه, one of the great companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they wanted to revenge from him because of what happened between the Muslims and those people at that time of the battles. And Khubayb took part in these battles, and he actually was very successful in participating and contributing to the defeat of those people of Quraysh, and also killed so many of them in these battles. So they wanted to avenge from him. So when they got him, they took him to At-Tan'im. And At-Tan'im is a place outside the Haram, which is known now as like the Masjid Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha, in that area, which is outside the Haram, because even at that time, they did not want to kill anyone inside the Haram area. So they took him outside the Haram boundaries in order to kill him and to avenge from him. And before they did that, Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked them to give him a chance to pray just two rak'ah before killing him. And he prayed the two rak'ah, and he did not make them long. And he told them, by Allah, I did not make them long because I don't want you to think that I'm afraid of death and I want to gain time. He prayed the two rak'ah, and it is said he was the first one to establish this kind of, to revive this kind of sunnah, to pray the two rak'ah before death. So they took him and they tied him, and all the people, they wanted to avenge from him. They start like beating him and hitting him, and they started even cutting from his body piece by piece. And they were asking him, Ya Khubayb, will you wish, أتود أن يكون محمد مكانك وأنت آمن أو أنت ناجٍ? They said, O Khubayb, would you like, is your wish now that Muhammad will be in your place and we will revenge from him and you'll be safe in your family? فقال لهم خبيب رضي الله تعالى عنه, ما أحب أن أكون آمنا في أهلي ومحمد تصيبه شوكة. He said, والله, I do not wish to be safe in my family and Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, even a thorn break into his foot. The least and the minimum harm can ever happen to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. I do not even wish that the minimum harm to happen to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, let alone being in my place now and being killed by you guys. خبيب رضي الله تعالى عنه رفع بصره إلى السماء. He raised his eyes up, and he said, Ya Allah, he made dua against them, Allahumma ahsihim adada wa uqtulhum badada wa la tubqi minhum ahada. He said, O Allah, count them in number and kill them one by one and do not save a single person from them. And even the people of Quraysh, they knew that this dua was going to happen to them. It was going to, inshallah, take care of them. But subhanallah, Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu said this dua, and they killed him after that. But who was watching this scene of Khubayb? One of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his name was Sa'id ibn Amir al-Jumuhi, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was with this group of people, like he was watching. And he was really shocked with the way that Khubayb, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, reacted to that kind of revenge from those people. And he said to himself that a man whose companions or whose friends are willing to sacrifice their life and they do not wish him the least harm to ever happen to him, that means that this man is a prophet and is a messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This incident had impacted Sa'id ibn Amir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And after that, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he reverted to Islam. And he participated with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Battle of Khaybar and whatever happened after that. Anyway, he continued sacrificing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until the time of Umar ibn Khattab, the Khilafah of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he became the Khalifa, then Sa'id ibn Amir al-Jumahi radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to him and he was giving him this advice. قال له يا عمر أوصيك أن تخشى الله في الناس ولا تخشى الناس في الله. He said, O Umar, I advise you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regardless of what the people will say. And do not fear the people and displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not do that. ثم قال له وأوصيك ألا يخالف قولك فعلك فإن القول ما صدقه الفعل. He said, I advise you that your words will not be different from your actions, because the real advice is what your actions, agrees with it. ثم قال له يا عمر أقم وجهك لمن ولاك الله أمره من بعيد المسلمين وقريبهم وأحب لهم ما تحب لنفسك وأهلك وأهل بيتك واكره لهم ما تكره لنفسك وأهل بيتك. And then he said to him, O Umar, be straightforward and be truthful in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given you of the responsibility with regard to the Muslims, the far of them and the near of them. And love for them what you love for yourself and your family, and hate for them what you hate for yourself and your family. ثم قال له يا عمر وخذ الغمرات إلى الحق لا تخف في الله لومة لائم. And be courageous in the truth and do not be afraid of anyone as long as you are pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال له عمر ومن يستطيع ذلك. عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه said to him, and who can do that? فقال له سعيد ابن عامر الجمحي رضي الله تعالى عنه قال يستطيع ذلك هؤلاء الذين والله ولاهم الله أمر أمة محمد وليس بينه وبين أحد مطلب. He said the one who can do that is the one that Allah put him in charge of the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is not looking for any gains from them because he only observes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that. فقال عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه then I will appoint you as an emir for Hims in Syria. فرفض سعيد ابن عامر الجمحي رضي الله تعالى عنه. Then عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه insisted and he said, you put me in this position and you do not want to help me. When Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked Sa'id ibn Amir to be the Amir of Hims and Sa'id radiallahu ta'ala anhu refused, then Umar said to him, you put me in this position and you're advising me to observe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to establish the truth and you guys do not help me. By Allah, I am not going to let it go. You will have to be the Amir of Hims. And eventually Sa'id ibn Amir radiallahu ta'ala anhu accepted that position and he was the Amir of Hims. One day, and this was the tradition of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that he used to ask the people in every city to give him a list of the people who are in need, the list of the poor people, so he can take care of them. So one day, a list of the poor people in Hims was given to Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and in the list was the Amir, Sa'id ibn Amir al-Jumahi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Qala lahum Umar, Amirukum faqir, your leader, your Amir is faqir, is poor? They said yes. وإنه ليمر عليه أو لتمر عليه الأيام الطوال ولا يوقد في بيته نار. They said, yes, by Allah, he is poor, and days pass after days after days, and no fire is kindled in his house. فبكى عمر حتى بلل لحيته. Then عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه cried until the tears wet his beard. ثم عمد. Then عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه got 1,000 dinar, إلى 1,000 dinar, and he sent them to سعيد ابن عامر الجمحي رضي الله تعالى عنه to help him in this situation. فلما وصل هذا المال إلى سعيد دخل على زوجته وهو يسترجع ويقول إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون. When this money reached سعيد, then he entered upon his wife and he started saying, indeed we all belong to Allah and indeed one day we shall return to him. إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون. She said, what happened? Anyone passed away? He said, no. دخلت علي الدنيا لتفسد علي آخرتي. He said, the dunya came to me in order to corrupt my akhirah. She said, what happened? And then he told her what Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu sent to him. She said then, if this is bothering you, then get rid of it. Then she said, he said to her, are you going to help me? Because he wants to make sure that she is with him on the same page. Are you going to help me? She said, yes. And then he distributed that money among all the poor Muslims in the city of Homs. Then one day, جاء عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه إلى Homs. It was also the tradition of عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه to go to these places to check what is happening to the people over there. He came to the people of Homs, and then he asked them about their Amir to see if he is doing his job properly, what is happening, and all these kind of things. قالوا له يا أمير المؤمنين نشكو إليك أميرنا في أربعة أشياء. They said, O أمير المؤمنين, we complain to you about our أمير regarding 4 things. Then he got سعيد بن عامر رضي الله تعالى عنه to ask him about these things. فقال لهم وما هي الشكوى الأولى, what is the first complaint? They said, كان سعيد رضي الله تعالى عنه لا يخرج إليهم حتى يتعالى النهار. يعني he is in that habit that he doesn't come out for his people until after sunrise, like long after sunrise. Then he said, يا سعيد, what's your response to that? How do you respond to these people? قال له سعيد رضي الله تعالى عنه والله يا أمير المؤمنين I was not planning to talk, like I did not have the intention to say anything because this is between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but since they complain about this, I'm going to justify why I come late to them. And then he said to him, I, like in the morning after I do the fajr and after like everything is done, so I take care of my family, I cook for them and I prepare the food for them, and I take care of their things during the daytime, and that takes some time from me, and that's why I get delayed and I do not come out until after sunrise. And then the second complaint they submitted to him was, لا يجيب أحدا بليل. يعني during the night time, if anyone asks him for anything, he will not come out for this person. And then he said to him, يا سعيد, what is your response to that? فقال يا أمير المؤمنين جعلت النهار لهم والليل لله عز وجل فأنا لا أجيب أحدا بليل لأن هذا الليل خصصته لله سبحانه وتعالى. He said, I made the daytime for them, for their service, but I made the night time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's why I do not answer anyone during the night time. ثم قال لهم وما هي شكواكم الثالثة, what is your third complaint? فقالوا له لا يخرج يوما كل شهر. There is a day during the month that he doesn't come out. فقال يا سعيد, what is your response for that? فقال له سعيد رضي الله تعالى عنه, I have only one dress and I wash it during that day and I wait until it dries and then I put it on and I go out for them. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked them, and what is your fourth complaint? فقالوا يا أمير المؤمنين من فترة إلى فترة أو من حين إلى حين تصيبه غشية. يعني from some time he will faint, he will fall unconscious, and he will not be aware of anything that is happening around him. And then he asked him, يا سعيد, what is your response for that? He said, أمير المؤمنين, whenever I remember the situation of Khubayb ibn Adi رضي الله تعالى عنه, when he was taken to At-Tan'im and the people of Quraysh were avenging from him, and I was helpless and I did not help him, I am afraid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold me responsible for that, and Allah will not forgive me for that. And by the way, Sa'id radiallahu ta'ala anhu, at that time he was not a Muslim, but he was concerned about this situation that Allah Azza wa Jal will ask him on the Day of Judgment, why didn't you help Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu? When Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu got all these answers from Sa'id radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he cried and he said, Alhamdulillah alladhi waffaqa Amir al-Mu'mineen lima yuhibbu Allah wa Rasuluh. Praise be to Allah who had given the tawfiq, the guidance to the Amir of Amir al-Mu'mineen to be on the right path and to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see the situation of both of them, the sacrifice of Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and the dedication of Sa'id ibn Amir al-Jumahi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and his sincerity and loyalty to the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his religion, and his dedication in his job, performing it properly according to the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his advice to Amir al-Mu'mineen in the beginning to fear Allah azza wa jal and to say the truth regarding those people that Allah azza wa jal put him in a charge. This is the way that the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were, and this is how they learned from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that's why they deserve what Allah azza wa jal described them with in the Quran by saying radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nas'al Allah azza wa jal an yajma'na wa iyyahum fil firdaws al-a'la ma'a an-nabiyyin was-siddiqin wash-shuhada'i was-salihin wa hasuna ulai'ika rafiqa. Allahumma amin ya rabbal alamin. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خير.